Okay, so the next hormone that I would love to shed some light on for you is what is called ghrelin. And I bet it's another hormone that you're unfamiliar with, right? So when you're running on an empty stomach, your stomach releases the hormone ghrelin. Ghrelin then sends a message to your brain telling you to eat. When you're full after a meal, ghrelin release is stopped and your brain doesn't get the signal to keep eating. Easy, right? In normal situations, ghrelin levels are at their peak before eating and lowest about an hour after you've had your meal. Now, studies have shown that when overweight and obese people eat a meal, their ghrelin levels only decrease slightly. But under normal conditions, ghrelin levels should halt completely. So this means that the brain doesn't receive as strong as a signal to stop eating, which leads to overeating in many cases. So when ghrelin is present, we get hungry, and most of us head to the pantry for a snack or a meal. Now this meal would then decrease ghrelin, and therefore it would relieve our hunger. But by doing so, we miss out on many of the benefits that ghrelin can offer, such as its potent ability to stimulate growth hormone. Now what this means is that when you eat less frequently and allow large amounts of ghrelin to be present in your body, you can effectively raise your human growth hormone levels. To take advantage of this growth hormone spike, it's important to also exercise while ghrelin levels are high, spiking growth hormone even more. Now, to properly take advantage of ghrelin, you need to adopt an intermittent fasting regimen and eat less frequently. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I would really advise you to also work out in a fasted state, preferably before your first meal of the day. Now this will allow you to work out when your ghrelin levels are at their peak, taking advantage of the elevated growth hormone levels. This will also help nutritionally replenish your body and muscles when you enjoy your first big meal after your workout. Now it turns out that breakfast, the supposed most important meal of the day, actually starts your day off by decreasing ghrelin. This sabotages your goal of better health and a better physique. Once you retrain your body to not expect food all day, or in this case, the first meal in the morning, these side effects of hunger become less of an issue due to the normalizing of your ghrelin levels. Now, your ghrelin levels also influence other factors, including your lifestyle habits. For example, lack of sleep increases ghrelin, making you feel hungry when you shouldn't be. Have you ever experienced the "should I go to bed or have a midnight snack" conundrum? This is a major reason why a lack of sleep is linked to weight gain. Stress, anger, sadness, and other negative emotions also alter these hunger hormones, which is why most people experiencing these emotions seek food for comfort and as a coping mechanism. Now, by getting all of your hormones, insulin, leptin, and ghrelin back to functioning properly with the help of intermittent fasting, you're going to look and feel your absolute best in no time.